안녕하세요. 안차키입니다. Stay with us and learn some useful Korean expressions. 지승현 선생님, 안녕하세요.
안녕하세요.
안녕하세요. 지승현입니다. It's really good to see you again. 만나서 반갑습니다. Now, in our last lesson, we learned how to use the word 고 to link two actions in one sentence. Now, let's get a quick review. 선생님, 어제 뭐 했어요?
영화를 보고 쇼핑을 했어요.
I see. 오늘은 뭐 할 거예요?
Well, I'm planning to go to the bookstore and get some book.
Do you have a particular book in mind?
No, not really. I'm going to buy a book for my friend.
Okay, well, now moving on to another interesting topic. Why don't we look at what is in store in this lesson?
Minhoek 씨, 오후에 뭐 할 거예요? 극장에 가서 영화를 볼 거예요. 나오미 씨는요?
수영장에 가서 수영을 할 거예요.
수영 잘해요?
네, 잘해요. 마이크 씨, 같이 갈래요?
아니요, 너무 피곤해요. 집에 가서 씻고 잘 거예요.
Michael asks Minhoek what he plans to do in the afternoon. Now, Minhoek answers that he's going to go watch a movie. Now, on the other hand, Naomi says she plans to go swimming. But everybody else is doing something, but Michael says that he's going to go home and get some rest. Now, let's get a check of the expressions in this lesson. This time, we'll learn how to add the expression 에 가서 to the word for a place to indicate what one does in a certain place. Now then, let's study some new words that we will need to learn the expressions.
수영장 수영장 수영하다 수영하다 도서관 도서관 책을 빌리다 책을 빌리다 극장 극장 영화를 보다 영화를 보다
Let's find out how these words are used in real situations.
극장에 가서 영화를 볼 거예요.
수영장에 가서 수영을 할 거예요.
집에 가서 씻고 잘 거예요. 극장에 가서 영화를 볼 거예요.
수영장에 가서 수영을 할 거예요.
집에 가서 씻고 잘 거예요.
Minhoek says that he's going to a theater to watch a movie. Now, what was the expression in Korean?
극장에 가서 영화를 볼 거예요. 극장에 가서 영화를 볼 거예요.
Naomi says she's going to the pool to swim. In Korean now,
수영장에 가서 수영을 할 거예요. 수영장에 가서 수영을 할 거예요.
Now, Michael says he's going home to wash and get some rest. Let's try this in Korean now.
집에 가서 씻고 잘 거예요. 집에 가서 씻고 잘 거예요.
Now, all three people used a similar expression in their sentences. They said 극장에 가서, 수영장에 가서, and 집에 가서.
That's right. To tell someone what to do at a certain place, just add the expression 에 가서 to the word for the place, followed by the word for the action taken. For example, let's say that I went to a restaurant and ate bibimbap. You can say
식당에 가서 비빔밥을 먹었어요.
Okay, then let's practice adding 에 가서 to the words that we have learned.
집, 집에 가서, 집에 가서 백화점에 가서 도서관에 가서 수영장에 가서
Now we'll practice adding some verbs to these phrases.
집에 가서 쉬었어요. 백화점에 가서 가방을 샀어요. 도서관에 가서 책을 빌렸어요. 수영장에 가서 수영을 했어요.
Easy, isn't it? Now, all you have to remember is to add 에 가서 to the word for the place, and you should have no problem. Well, then why don't we polish up on the expressions with a little dialogue.
어제 뭐 했어요? 수영장에 가서 수영을 했어요. 수영장에 가서 수영을 했어요. 어제 뭐 했어요? 백화점에 가서 가방을 샀어요. 백화점에 가서 가방을 샀어요. 오늘 뭐 할 거예요?
도서관에 가서 책을 빌릴 거예요.
도서관에 가서 책을 빌릴 거예요. 오늘 뭐 할 거예요?
집에 가서 쉴 거예요.
집에 가서 쉴 거예요.
Do you recall Michael saying that he was very tired? Now, what was the expression in Korean?
너무 피곤해요. 너무 피곤해요.
너무 means too or very, and 피곤해요 means that Michael is tired, right? Okay, please remember that the word 너무 usually has a negative connotation. Okay, let's try saying the word.
너무, 너무, 너무.
Michael is very tired and he says that he's going to go home, wash, and get some rest. Now, how did he say this?
집에 가서 씻고 잘 거예요.
잘 거예요 means I'm going to go to sleep. And 자다 is the infinitive meaning to sleep. Well then, let's go over what we have learned up to this point along with the video clip.